When we showed old people and fatsos on our site, we were celebrating our old people and fatsos. They were really important to the community. And they still are at the individual boxes, and they get celebrated there. And I love asking the question because it really matters to me, how many of my affiliates have had a client lose 100 pounds? And at HQ, you know, we started posting early, and we said that these workouts will exceed the demands of the world's fittest human beings. That these workouts, applying yourself 100% day in, day out, will tear you up. I don't care who you are. They will win, you will lose. That's what that represents. And that was just to claim some turf up here at the very pointy end of the spear, and then we were going to backfill from there. And I had observed years and years ago in our industry that wherever you establish a beat, we can establish this kind of a Maslowian hierarchy of need, from people who have whose lives depend on fitness, livelihood depend on fitness, and then all kinds of stratification of committed amateur. And my observation was, just as a business observation, that wherever you establish a beachhead, you could from then and there only go down. And so once you're Richard Simmons and you've gotten more 100 pounds off of more fat gals than anyone else, there would be nothing he could do, no matter how potent it was, that would get the attention of the Navy SEALs. Right, Tony? Would you be willing to work out with Richard Simmons? It's very unlikely. In your day, when you were in the teams, it wasn't going to happen, right? And yet, like, Stu Smith's Navy SEAL Fitness has sold over 1 million copies. There haven't been 1 million SEALs. Who's buying the fucking book? Well, grandmas and grandpas and kids and children, and, you know, its value is aspirational. And we decided, we elected to be that from CrossFit.com. All the while aware of the need and the inevitability of fat fuck CrossFit, old lady CrossFit, missing two limbs CrossFit. I mean, all those things are gonna be there eventually and need to be there, but I can't do that from the front end always. Similarly at the games, I mean, you know, the idea here is the world's fittest man and fittest woman, and already it's like, well, what about fit kids, fit old ladies, fit men, fit missing a right leg, fit, you know, half stupid, I mean, you know, and those things will happen, but we're gonna run with the ball here at the very nose end of this thing and let others backfill, and it's very important work. But the truth of the matter is what drives this thing is the ma and pa kettles. It's the 41-year-old super soccer mom that's really the star client at the affiliates boxes. She's the one bringing in the other people and doing the whole thing. Our affiliates estimation is that it's somewhere around 60% of the client base is soccer mom. What we call these super moms. They're running with the movement. I had a similar question that came out of it internally from staff. Ms. Susanna Dial, just point right to her. She was saying that in moving with Spike, we got this kind of 18 to 25-year-old UFC-loving male demographic, and there's nothing really for women. And I was like, yeah, I get that, you know, but I'm okay with it. And the reason I'm okay with it has to do with our women. If I start parading someone or something around where its chief attribute that is just that this is really good for a female, or, you know, if we cater to that to the extent that it's been suggested, and we soften things up till it has some of the flavor of the, what is it, oxygen channel or network, what happens is for every one of those gals that comes around, now finally something for women, you know, ladies night at CrossFit, what's going to happen is that the hardcore women that are at the heart of this thing are going to leave us. I've got a lot of gals that are around because they thrive in this supercharged testosterone-rich environment, and they're not afraid of men or competing against them, working out with them, listening to their bad manners, attitude, or style. And those are the girls that we've pretty much at HQ decided we want to keep them around. You know, I don't want to change the female demographic of CrossFit at all. Our ladies are really special. They're really tough, and we don't have to apologize for being who we are as guys around them often, you know. And it's a very comfortable place. Correct me if I'm wrong, ladies, but I think we're on the right track with what we're doing for women. Yeah, thanks. Yeah, this is a matriarchy here that may not be abundantly clear to everyone. But this organization is owned, run, supported, managed. There's the women are at least partners with men in every sense.